legit.
Nah, she legit. Up. Nah, she legit. She would whack 100 on the. She with the 100 in ENT. She work in the court system. She get everybody paperwork, man. Yes.
I don't know. I ain't no lawyer, so I ain't no reason for me to argue about it. But I feel how I feel. I feel like
you did. Hey, but shit, but you know, sometimes you, nigga, that's why I said, sometimes you could be a snitch and it not be in paperwork, though. Like I tell people, just because it ain't in paperwork don't mean niggas don't give information that's not used in, to arrest niggas.
They'll do what?
You see what I'm saying? I can give you information and be like, yo, I'm not signing no statement. I don't have to sign a statement, right? But give you information.
But yeah, they could do that, too.
They do it all the time. Niggas will give information, but say, I don't want to sign no statement. Just do what you need to do. Now you know, nigga.
I know.
Figure it out.
I know a few people that did that.
Figure it out. Put the pieces together. Man, I know niggas that will call anonymous to the police station to detectives and get them narcotic niggas tips.
Yeah, that man got picked up in 2006, and he didn't get his time until 2008. My son was born in 2003. He's 21. This nigga got over 30 years, man. So you telling me this man done did? This man ain't did no close to no 30 years.
He did 20.
My cousin went to jail for conspiracy, and he was by himself, and he got 20 years. He had to do 14 before he got out.
He did 20 to 30.
And this man was nonviolent, and he was never implicated in no murders.
We know he did something. I think he working. See, people think people snitching. He don't got to be a snitch. He could be just working for the police now.
That's the same thing.
Like, niggas could be like, yo, you know what? We going to let you out and use you like a hip-hop cop. You are next piece. Why?
But ain't that snitching?
And let me tell y'all the game. Know why that's a good move for the federal government? Because everybody right now, what they want right now, everybody wants. You know, don't put her out right now. Just speak. Right now, everybody's gonna want to sit with them, meet with them, kick it with them, podcast with them, allow him to talk money with them. They're gonna use him as a jewel.
Can you hear me, Cal?
Yeah.
That's the same thing Lil Woody doing though.
But they do the shit they do with him, they did with Alpo. Like when they let Alpo out, he was doing the same shit. That's how Alpo got killed. Alpo was still working for the police.
Yeah, he told and all that shit too.
And when he got out, he was still working.
Yeah, then he ended up getting whacked.
Yeah. And the nigga that whacked him got off. He just beat the case.
Did he?
Yep. Nigga that whacked him just beat the trial.
I normally be keeping up with that thing.
That's how I know that it was set up, because how the fuck did he beat the trial?
Man, because they want to make sure they didn't have to deal with him again on that level.
Exactly. They knew what it was. They knew what the fuck he was doing. He was supposed to be in witness protection in Vermont.
And they knew he
came back to the city and said, fuck witness protection.
I mean, how can they trust him when he killed his own friends over some money?
Bro, but that's what they did, bro. They put that nigga in witness protection. He was living under a whole different name, my nigga, in Vermont.
Vermont. Somebody found him.
That he got found. And once they found the nigga and started telling him where his address, he just popped out of the blue like, fuck everybody, I don't care. And he started coming to the city, started being in Harlem, and then he got popped. And then once he got popped, which I think has something to do with them people. Why? Because he wouldn't listen. He violated what they told him to do.
Right.
Once you violate the code, my nigga, you going against the grain. Now you want us to play with you again? You feel me?
Yeah.
And that's what a lot of these niggas do, bro. So when I say NBA young boy doing a lot of talking, let's show this, y'all. Let's get to it.
Yeah, I want to see it. Although I already believe you on this one.
knife and nail. It's just when a girl grabs that knife, she hurt. Mm-hmm. That's what I keep telling him, man. Like, the girl ain't doing nothing wrong. The girl who got stabbed, she gonna tell you that, man, she didn't stab, but like, she didn't try. The girl who got.
As you see, we just started the video and he already telling, right?
He's talking about him.
We already just started the video and your favorite rapper's already snitching.
You don't even hear him talk this much in real life.
Bro, they didn't even have to take this nigga to the precinct.
That boy didn't get no chicken. He ain't get a soda. Nothing.
Bro, he's smoking these Newports. And he gonna tell these police officers anything they wanna know. He's snitching on his baby mother.
They gave that man a box of Newports, man. He went off.
Snitching on his baby mother. Come on, man. Y'all, this nigga ain't know what y'all think he is. Pay attention.
Why is he? It's just when a girl grabbed her, the knife hit her. Mm-hmm. That's what I keep telling him, man. Like, the girl ain't doing nothing wrong. The girl who got stabbed, she gonna tell you that, man, she didn't stab, but like, she didn't try. Ain't no weapons in here, nothing.
Yeah, that's
I
no
kept
good,
telling man. Him though. I paid him my money. I kept telling him, man, them niggas ain't do nothing.
Yeah.
The one with the hell, I guess he the owner of the company, and the one outside worked for him.
Mm-hmm.
Man, bullshit, man. For one, the whole time you heard me raising my the whole time you heard me raising my tongue.
Bro, what happened? You had put out the house. Because he was trying to say you put some water out the house.
Her stuff was out in front. She was out front, and she went in the car with the security guard. Then she got out of the car and walked back.
That's the problem.
In front of her in the back.
That's the problem. She never was in the backyard, right?
That's what he said.
Man, tell me why I was looking for this girl the whole time. She was in his car.
So he ain't doing too much talking. Don't he sound like he mad because Mayweather daughter was being protected by the security guard?
So
Mayweather daughter being protected by the security guard.
He got mad.
Because they in a domestic violence situation at this moment. And he's upset. And he's upset. He running around the compound looking for Yaya and can't find Yaya.
Yeah, he's saying, man, I'm paying these niggas and they protecting her.
Exactly. But he must not know who the hell her daddy is.
Yeah, ain't nobody want to be dealing with that.
Nigga, do you know who her daddy is?
Hey, they'll never get a security job again nowhere.
They probably like, nigga, you got money, but nigga... They probably made one phone call to her daddy, like, yo, my nigga, some shit going on right now with your daughter. Yeah. They probably know the security company. Yeah.
I guarantee they called them.
Yeah, and I bet you they probably know the security company that be securing him.
All right. Mayweather said, hey man, y'all better watch my daughter. Y'all it's up for y'all. They were like, we don't want no smoke.
Like this shit crazy, but he doing all the talking. You supposed to say, I don't know nothing. This ain't got nothing to do with me.
That's all I'd have said. I'd be like, bro, I didn't see nothing.
This a fight. This a fight between two girls.
Yeah, I didn't know that they was even fighting. Look at my house. How am I supposed to know where they at in here?
But. Y'all believe this nigga? My
question is, how they both end up in the same house and he didn't? Well, I mean, I'm pretty sure he knew, but how they even end up in the same place at the same time like that?
Because he had both of the baby mothers come over and they at different times and they ended up coming at the same day. Like Yaya was already there. She supposed to be leaving in the morning. And he had the other baby mother coming in, but she probably came in early. So now you got two baby mothers. And she like, what the fuck?
Yeah. Now, okay. now the story's starting to come together. It still don't come together while he said nothing, but it's starting to come together for me.
So now he tried to kick Yaya out because the other baby mother back.
Yeah, now it makes sense. Now yeah, that's why I was like, why would he try to kick her out? It's because he knew he's about to get caught.
Mm-hmm.
And she didn't want that smoke.
That's why I said it's a dirty game, my nigga. Be careful who you allow to fuck with you. And then these niggas don't be living how you think, my nigga. This nigga house dirty.
Oh, yeah, come on now. Do he look like he don't even look like he cleaned up when he didn't? He don't even look like he cleaned up. Now, I could see him maybe having a maid service or something.
But that's my point. Why wouldn't you have a maid service? These niggas don't look like you ain't got no maid service. We talking about
crap everywhere. Young boy is almost a billionaire.
And ain't got no maid service. I'm talking about clothes everywhere, all over the middle of the floor.
But you know what, though? I noticed if you ever watch these young nigga videos, they all be like that. They got all that money, and you would think they got all the most lavish stuff. They don't.
That's crazy.
And the only way they do is if they get like an interior decorator to come do it for them. And then after the interior decorator come, they don't do anything else to that house, man. It'd be trashed out. But yeah, but to stick to the subject, that man sat there and told the police everything. And he didn't wait for a soda. He didn't get a drink.
And if he telling on her,
they probably gave him two Newports.
And if he telling on her, what makes you think he ain't gonna tell on these little niggas in the street under him? That's why I say people need to pay attention. If this nigga will tell on his baby mother, if you see how he telling the whole event, what happened, who had what happened when he went outside, he'll tell on anybody. This is what street niggas do. This not what street niggas do when somebody just got stabbed in their house.
You can stab them. Now, maybe if we was in the streets and there wasn't nobody I was related to, and they asked me, did I see it? I might not even be like, man, I ain't see nothing, you know? Because if that was my kid and I knew somebody seen it, I would want them to say something. But in my house?
But listen, they know. This is my point, no monkey business. They know who did it. It's only three people in the crib. Him.
But what I'm saying is I'm on parole. I'm not implicating nothing. I ain't seen nothing. I don't even know what happened.
But that's my point. It's a closed and shut investigation. They got Yaya because she in the car. Yaya gonna tell y'all what happened, right? She gonna tell you she got my baby mother. Mother can't deny that because she's here. Why do I need to tell you anything? I don't know.
But see, here's the problem with him saying something. Because, see, it's going to still come back to bite him in the ass regardless. Because, see, once he said he's seen it, now when they go to court, he got to go up there and testify.
That's what I'm saying. What people don't understand, even when you don't write a statement, long as they got it on body camera footage, that's all they need.
Right. But his words are key to what happened, too, even though they know she did it. It makes it stick even harder because now you got somebody who's involved with both of you.
That's why she couldn't beat it in court. She couldn't beat it. Yaya, I think she got like 15 years probation for this year, 20 years probation.
Yeah.
She couldn't beat it in court. Floyd Mayweather was going to court with her and everything. They couldn't beat it because of young boy testimony. Young boy, what he told the police. Now, if it was her word against the other person's word, she probably would have beat the stabbing. Could have got it self-defense. Said the other girl attacked her.
Right.
It would have been her word against her word. But why did she get charged? Why did she get 20 years probation? It's because they have NBA Youngboy on video telling them exactly what happened. You understand?
Right.
So if Yaya wanted to beat this, how you gonna beat it when your own baby daddy's snitching on you? Your own baby daddy is on camera. Look at him. Look at him, y'all. Look at him. Y'all can't, we can't make this shit up. Look at the, look at the, look at NBA YoungBoy snitching on Yaya.
That's when a girl grabbed her tonight, hit her.
Singing like a bird.
That's what I keep telling him, man. Like, my girl ain't doing nothing wrong. The girl who got stabbed, she gonna tell you that, man, she didn't stab, but like, she didn't try. Ain't no weapons in here, nothing.
Yeah, that's
no good. I kept telling him, though, I paid him my money. I kept telling him, man, them ain't do nothing.
Yeah.
The one with the hell, I guess.
You hear what he keeps saying? He kept saying, I paid him. He talking about the security guards. I paid him. Niggas didn't do nothing.
Yeah, but he trying to put it off on them too.
He trying to put it off on them because he feel like, if I, what am I paying y'all for and y'all not securing, what's going on?
Yeah, so he trying to dump it off on them.
How you allow Yaya to even get a knife and be in my house and all this commotion going on and y'all my security?
He basically saying they ain't securing nothing.
But you know what the security saying? We don't get paid to get between your sexual conflict with your girlfriends.
I mean, technically they don't though.
Like we are to protect you, protect the outside of your house, make sure nobody coming in, secure the premises. We not supposed to come in your house and protect you from your arguments with your wife, your girlfriend. I think this nigga think he Michael Jackson now. Only nigga that had that type of security was Michael Jackson, if I believe.
Who you think? Oh yeah, Mike did have some good security.
Yeah, I think only Michael Jackson would be the only nigga where even his girl couldn't hit him. Nigga, like if she tried to swing, they catch the punch.
You think so?
Yup.
He said yup. That's crazy, cause I you know what? I ain't gonna lie to you. I believe that wholeheartedly. You couldn't lay a finger on that man.
They said Michael Jackson beat up Tupac.
Yeah, I was gonna say, y'all was just getting ready to say that. I said, man, Michael Jackson beat up Tupac, man.
And I don't even think he beat him up I think it was the point where Tupac knew I'm better off not fight back.
I think he just roughed him up real good just so he could get the point.
But I think Tupac knew you can't fight this nigga back. It's an army behind this nigga right now. If you try to fight, imagine trying to fight Michael Jackson back. You know how many Nation of Islam niggas and security niggas be around this nigga?
Man, you're gonna have to fight. You're gonna have to fight everybody. Chinese, you're gonna come from everywhere. You're gonna have to fight Chinese people. You're gonna have to fight everybody, man.
And your career will be over.
Over.
Nigga, you beat up Michael Jackson. What? Nigga, I'd rather say I lost to Michael Jackson. I'd rather say I let Michael Jackson whoop my ass. I'm pretty sure Tupac was alive and he told you, he'd be like, hell yeah, I let Michael Jackson whoop my ass. What?
Man, like, listen. They're going to look at you like, think about if me and you knew about that fight back then. We would never listen to Tupac no more.
No, we'd have looked at him like he was crazy.
Like he's crazy. And I'm and people like, oh man, Mike ain't like, yeah, he really would like that. That's why they, man, listen, not to get off subject, but that's why they killed him. He owned, that man owned 50% of a record label and everybody publishes.
Man, they've been doing to a lot of people, ODs, my nigga.
They
was an OD, just like Rich Homie Quan was an OD, just like Prince was an OD. They've been doing it for years, my nigga. And they gonna continue to do it. Just like Whitney Houston was an OD, right?
Yeah.
The only difference is some ODs is a little bit different than the others. You either want OD in the tub and drown, you want OD drink. My nigga, it all boils down to an OD. I keep telling people, it's harder to shoot you because it's evidence left behind. But when a nigga OD, all we got to say is you was a drug user.
That's it. Because like Rich Homie Quan, ain't nobody about to live too far off in there. because you got to think about it, he was already, we knew he popped pills and did shit like that, because he even said it in the song. So it wasn't too much to investigate. Everybody, this is what everybody going to do. We're going to chop it up, and man, he must have some fentanyl.
But you know how I know, you know how I know that was a setup? You want to know how I know it was a setup?
Yeah, you know.
Because when you watch the video, nobody's emotional.
Oh, yeah, his brother and his girlfriend, all that.
None of them was emotional, bro.
They're supposed to be going crazy.
That's my whole point, bro. When you, and that's how I say what people don't understand. That's how God works in mysterious ways. That's the spirit in your body.
I ain't gonna lie though, Cap.
It's hard to fake emotion, my nigga.
But when my brother first, when my other brother, my older one, when he died in front of me, man, I was trying to do CPR and everything, man. And you would think I'd be hysterical, man. I didn't even cry.
That's not my point. I understand certain people don't cry, but what's the odds that 3 out of 3 people not crying?
Yeah, no, I get that. I'm just saying maybe he was in shock. Maybe
I ain't talking about just him. He wasn't the only one there.
Now the woman, I don't know.
But like I'm looking at multiple people that's in that house that expressed no emotion, my nigga.
Statistically, you would think that the women would be going crying a little bit.
And it's not even just that. My nigga, you got to look at statistics in general. It's 3 or 4 people in the crib. Nigga, at least 1 or 2 niggas is going to be emotional.
But that's what I'm saying. Statistically, somebody in there is supposed to be.
Yeah.
One.
Somebody supposed to be calming people down. Don't worry,
okay, look. Okay, look. When my brother died, I had to deal with all that stuff, but my niece was going crazy. I'm trying to deal with my niece. You know what I'm saying? She going crazy. Then I'm dealing with my sister. She was kind of calm, but she was still, you know, going through it. And I had the kids there, so okay. I had to get off, and I had to deal with all.
So you saw all different emotions from all different people, right?
From all different people. It was
we saw the same emotion from all them people.
Right. That's
collect.
But that's what I'm saying. It just seemed weird. Oh, like nobody.
Even a police can tell you that. Nigga, you don't get that when you go to a scene, a crime scene, where somebody's about to die. It's never that calm, my nigga. Mm-hmm. It's never that calm. It was the family members was calm, almost like they did a motherfucking ritual before they got there.
Like they expected it.
No, it was almost like they did the ritual. Fuck expecting it. Even when you my nigga, I had uncles that we expected to die because he was a crackhead. We knew eventually he was gonna die. But guess what? We still cried when he died.
Right.
It was almost like them niggas did a ritual and them niggas was preparing for the moment. Like this shit was a sad.
Yeah, because when somebody died, you don't know they're gonna die. You can't prepare for that.
Man, that shit was put together like a motherfucker, my nigga.
Nah, for real.
It's almost like certain people know that, like, the generational wealth going, what they got to do. It's like niggas will sacrifice lives, themselves, to keep money moving.
Yeah, that's what they're doing.
And sometimes it be the people close to you that sacrifice you. If they don't convince you to sacrifice yourself by crashing out, then they sacrifice you.
How you feel about Gucci Mane dropping everybody? Because speaking of sacrifice,
They didn't die quick enough.
And then on top of that, I feel like that one dude Jay. Even though we don't know who he is.
I'm sorry to interrupt. That's just information on our new machines that we're gonna start using on Monday.
All right, thank you. But like that dude Jay, he's supposed to have been signed to him. We all know who Jay is, but Jay was like, man, I'm glad. He said, man, because it was about to be a whole lot of stuff that was about to come out. You know what I'm saying? It was about to be a bunch of stuff to come out, so it kind of looks suspicious. You know what I'm saying? That he dropped everybody, even though it is a business move.
Bro, that's what they do in the industry. That's what, bro, he ain't doing nothing that everybody don't do in the industry. They've been dropping people for the longest. All only difference is that he announced it.
Yeah, no, I don't feel like Gucci did nothing wrong.
All he did was just announce it. Everybody get dropped. Everybody get dropped.
Everybody does.
You, you either get dropped or you get shelved.
But look how many Gucci Mane artists die or end up in prison.
But the prison don't put money in his pocket. When they die, put money in his pocket.
Yeah, that's right. But he kept Pusha T and he kept Fujiano.
Because them is the two closest niggas to die.
Yeah, but you could be right. But they got a lot of money.
My nigga, they are the closest two niggas to dying, and they make money. And they make money.
I guarantee when they get out and they start making about two or three more albums, they mysteriously die in a shootout. So now he got all this money. He got this life insurance on him.
My nigga.
Money, and he going to make millions off of them. He ain't going to split it with them.
You know what he's about to do, bro? See, people don't even peep what he's about to do. It's about to be tax season, bro. You do know that, right?
Yeah.
Right now.